So Creality sent me their new Halot One Plus 3D printer, so let's check it out and see if it's any good. It did come with a standard goodie bag of all the tools needed to work with this printer, along with the manual and a replacement FEP sheet. And it does have a nice large aluminum vat and can hold a max of 650 milliliters of resin. And like most printers on the market now, it has dual linear rails for the Z-axis. It is good to see that it has an active charcoal filter built in and it's replaceable. One annoying thing is the power switch is on the back of this machine, so you have to reach all the way around it to turn it on, but once it is turned on, it will show this little animation and then prompt you to set up your language and your Wi-Fi. You don't have to put your Wi-Fi in right away, just wait a couple seconds and it will allow you to go to the home screen. And once you're here, you can set up everything how you'd like. And the first thing I did after connecting this to my Wi-Fi was install the updates that this machine needed. The build plate design is exactly the same as almost all the other Creality printers, and they work perfectly fine. And it's easy enough just to slide onto the machine and tighten down the knob. And before we can print anything, we have to level the bed, and to do this I just need to loosen up the four bolts on the sides of the build plate. And I could just take the leveling card that came with the printer and just put it directly onto the screen, after removing the vat of course. In the printer itself, I want to go to settings, then print settings, Z-axis movement, and finally leveling. And this will start your leveling process and lower your build plate down to your screen. And if you happen to be using this as some sort of tutorial, make sure you loosen those bolts all the way or you're going to damage your machine. But anyways, once it stops moving, go ahead and tighten all the bolts up and you should be good to go. And just push that leveling button again and it will raise up your build plate. And you'll be able to reinstall your vat and remove your paper. For the first print, I'm going to be using some Aqua 4K resin from Frozen, seeing that this is a 4K printer. And using a USB drive, I'm going to upload the file for printing. And once that's done uploading, it is now on the machine itself. And once you open it, it will give you the option to change the print file settings or to keep them how they are already. And after that, I could just start the print. And with it already printing and the file on the machine, you can remove the USB drive and it won't change anything. And about 3 hours later, I have my first finished print. And once I clean this off in some alcohol, here's how the print looks. And it looks like it came out really good with really crisp line work and all the details. And once I got all the supports off and glued it all together, here's how it looks. And it looks really good in my opinion. So I decided to print about 5 full beds worth of more parts. And as you can see, they came out really good with no failures and incredible detail. But this next print didn't come out perfect. You can see here that it's missing a piece. It needed some supports that I didn't realize. And then it had some layer splitting on the base of this, and it was making a lot of noise when trying to peel this off of the FEP sheet. So it was just sticking a little too well. So I thought I'd switch it up and try printing with some Soriatech cast. Seeing that this stuff is harder to print with and has longer exposure times, I wanted to see if this could even print this stuff or if there was any more problems. And at first glance, it looks like it printed out perfectly. But if we look a little bit closer, all of the rings are oval shaped for some reason, meaning that stuff is sticking to the bed a little too much still and actually stretching the model. And after emptying and cleaning the vat, I found out that there was some resin actually embedded in the FEP sheet and already showing a bunch of wear. And seeing that they provided a extra FEP sheet, I'm going to switch this out. Which is easy enough to do, just remove all the bolts on the bottom of this and it comes apart and you put the new one in. And I did notice before removing the bolts, the FEP sheet wasn't as tight as they normally are. And then after installing the new one, it was much tighter. So now I can throw this back on the machine, and I'm going to try printing some of the water washable resin from Creality. But this time I'm going to be doing a lot more calibration testing to make sure everything's going to work right. And for my calibration test of choice, I'm going to be using the cones of calibration from Table Flip Foundry. And it's pretty straightforward. One side of it is meant to fail, and the other side is meant to succeed by the two cones touching. And you just change your exposure time to make sure everything looks the way you want it. And to do this without reslicing it, you can change all the parameters in your settings right on the printer before actually starting the print. And once you have that all dialed in, they have a miniature that's pre-supported that you can print to make sure everything is working perfectly. And this was successful, and all the supports came off of it really easily. And a closer look at the model, everything came out really good, fine details and everything like that. It is white, so it's really hard to pick up on camera, but from what you can see, it is pretty good. And I've done several prints now with different resins, and the sticking problem is no longer a thing. But it's something definitely I'm going to look out for and make sure to update everyone if it comes back. So let me go over some of the features with this machine real quick. It is Wi-Fi enabled, so you can connect to it with your phone using the Creality Cloud app. This also allows you to download files from their store and print them directly from your phone using the built-in slicing software. Another interesting thing is you can plug a webcam into this and watch your prints in real time through the app, but it doesn't come with a webcam. I have one from my other Creality machine, and it plugs in and works with no problem. I also tried just a normal Logitech one, and it also worked with no problem. So I made a quick little data sheet to show you the difference between this printer and the other 4K printers that are on the market right now, so you can quickly compare each one to one another and see what would be right for you. And honestly, this printer is doing really well for me now, after fixing the weird sticking problem it had, and I hope that it's just a fluke problem with the FEP sheet somehow. But if it starts happening again, I will make sure to update the first comment on this video to let you know. I hope you found this to be helpful, and if you have any questions, leave a comment. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.